Hello, in this video we will be creating hair that you can see in here. We will be creating the mesh textures and then we will import those from Blender to Character Creator and we will set up the hair shader. So the first step is to export this character into Blender for the reference. So we go to the file, export FBX. We select Blender preset. We don't need textures, so we can disable this and we will can only select the mesh option. We don't need the motion. So I click export and then in my folder I created subfolder character and in here you can save your file. So now inside Blender we will start by creating textures. So from the right sidebar we open hair tool panel and in here we click open baking scene. So now the baking scene is loaded with a particular hair setup that can be already used for baking. You don't have to change anything if you don't want to. And character creator is using few of those passes on the right, so we will use ambient occlusion, opacity, root map for good for coloring the hair tips, then random ID mask that is good for randomly coloring random hairs, and then for the specular we can use flow or directional map, but the directional maps gives slightly better results, so we will use this one, and we can use also depth map, so we will select with shift click all the maps that can be used in the character creator and then you can select the output path. So in my case I have this folder created in the hair textures and I already baked this to save time, but you just click accept to select the folder and you can click bake to bake those hair. If you want you can change the resolution or quality of the bake. Now I will import the character to new blend file. So I will search file import FBX, search for the character and we have now this imported after a second. And now I can do the hair modeling. I will use preset to speed up the work from the library. I will use hair long preset. I will just append this and now I can move this to the correct position. And if you want, you can remove the actual hair and just work with grid surface. And later we can regenerate the hair from this grid. I am looking for intersections around the head so that the hair strand won't clip through the head geometry. It is looking okay, but in front there is intersection. So I will select the front part and move this outside of the body using linear deformer from Mira Tools addon. I will give you a link to this free addon in the video description. So now I can generate curves and hair again using the Ctrl Shift H pipe menu. And it is looking quite a bit better. If you have more time, then you can manually fix the remaining intersections using the hair modeling tool. But I want to keep this video short. Another tip is that you may want to add more volume to the hair, so you can just select grid surface and generate another layer of hair cards, but they will overlap exactly on top of the old ones, so you may want to change noise seed to change the position of the new hair strands and you can offset them slightly above and then probably add more transparent texture so that you will create the volumetric effect this way, but to keep this simple I will just use this one layer. Okay, so this is using the default UVs and default texture, so I will fix this right now. I will open UV image editor and we will import the previously baked hair texture opacity map. And now I will update the UVs to use this new texture, so we do this with this hair UV button. And I will just move the position of this UV box and now this way we can use this part of the texture on the hair strands. If you make full hair, then you would probably want to create UV boxes for all the texture in here. But for now I will just use this one spot to make this quick. Now it is time to update the texture in itself. To change this from the default texture to this one. So we will edit the shader by going to the shader editor and we will change the default texture to this one. So I will copy this name and I will replace the default one texture to this opacity PNG. And if you don't want to do this manually for every material slot, you can just use this material UV refresh button. And now every material is using this new texture. And basically we have the ready hair ready to go for exporting. But I just want to show you one common problem that you can see in here, that we can see the character skin through the hair. The most common way to fix this is to paint fake shadow layer on top of the hair, on top of the head. And we do this by just duplicating the head. We will duplicate this part of the head like so, and on this duplicated part we can paint the fake shadow. So I will just do this quickly. We press shift D to duplicate, P to select, separate the selection, and now with this new separated mesh we can push this with Alt S slightly outside so it won't intersect the head. We will clean up the old materials and we will clean up old vertex groups and shape keys, and I will create new material. Let's name this shadow, and we can now start painting on the shadows in here. So I will switch to texture paint, but one problem is that we don't have texture, so I will create image new. Let's name this shadow, and it doesn't have to be big, because it will be just dark texture without much detail. So okay, we have this still pink color. It is because when we paint, we have selected material, but material has no texture. So in the material node editor, we have to add this texture that we just created. So we search for image. We plug the image texture node, and in the node we search for the new created shadow texture. And we plug alpha channel to alpha of the material. So this way we can paint opacity mask on this shadow layer. Let's start painting the opacity alpha channel by changing the mix mode to erase alpha. And if I paint now, you see we have this ugly sharp edge. It is because in the material properties you have to change the alpha blend mode to hashed, and it still doesn't look good. But if you change the viewport shading to material, now we have this softer, nicer look. If I decrease the brightness of the material, you will have this kind of soft looking material thing. If you spend more time on this, it would look like fake shadow. And if I unhide the hair, you will see that instead of the skin color, we see now the dark color of this fake shadow layer. In here we have the final version of the hair. It was made using the same techniques as I showed you previously, except I spent around hour or two on tweaking to make it look more volumetric. So we have a few curve objects, then we have grid surfaces that were used to generate the hair, and we have also the final fake shadow scalp mask. To export the objects, we just select everything except your character, and we will use Ctrl-Shift-H finalize hair. This will create new object that merged copy, and you see the original objects are not affected. I will undo the translation, and if I want to isolate the new copy using the Shift-H. So we have now only visible this one object. I will rename this to hair long, and I want to show you also the materials of this object. So we have two materials, one for the scalp mask, one for the hair. I will rename the hair material to hair, and if we go to object mode, I can select only the first material, and if I move this without soft selection, you will see the scalp mask is hidden below. Okay, now I want to add vertex color. To do this, I will use Ctrl-Shift-H, bake ambient occlusion. And we don't see any result, because we have to switch viewport to solid, and then in the viewport shading color, enable vertex. So we still don't see the difference, because in the mesh properties, vertex colors, we have two layers. So I will remove the first empty layer, and now we see the ambient occlusion layer. So now I will just use the bake ambient occlusion again, and I will tweak the settings by going to the bottom right, bottom left. I will increase the bounces, maybe increase the smoothness, enable double-sided, and maybe I will reduce the distance to 0.03. In my case, it looks okay. So now we are ready to export. We have the UVs, we have the vertex color. So now to export, I will just press File, Export, and FBX. In my case, I named this Hair Long FBX. I will select Selected Only, Mesh, and then Export. When you have your mesh selected and exported, you can remove the merged copy by pressing X Delete and unhide your other objects using Alt H. You can continue working on your original objects if you want, and then just repeat the last steps to export. So just select everything, finalize to get this new mesh copy for exporting. Now we will switch to the character creator. So finally we switch to the character creator, and now I will import the hair using the create menu, accessory, and then just select the FBX file that you exported from Blender. And we have the geometry properly imported. I can now set up the textures and shader. You can do this from this right side menu, use this checkboard icon, and at the very top we have the hair material and the scalp mask. I want to set up the scalp mask, but first I will reduce the opacity of the hair so we can see its geometry correctly. And now I will switch to the scalp mask and I will drag and drop the opacity texture for the scalp. And thanks to this we have the softer edges and it will look more convincing as the fake shadow. Usually you want to avoid using completely dark and completely black colors, so I will reduce the opacity slightly like so, so it is not that dark. And now let's jump back to the hair. I will increase its opacity, and first thing to set up hair shader is to use proper shader. In here we have the option to select the traditional PBR SSS or digital human hair shader. And when I selected it, you can see that the appearance of the geometry changed and the light that was behind is now shining through the hair geometry. So let's set up the textures. I will drag and drop them one by one. First the opacity texture. Then I will plug in the ambient occlusion. And finally I will plug in the depth pass into blend slot. I will show you actually the influence from the depth pass with close-up, and if I decrease the strength of this layer, you see that the hair is looking quite flat, but if I increase it is giving more volumetric look. Also by default the hair shader is using the vertex color, and you may remember we baked the ambient occlusion, so without vertex color the hair is looking a bit flat also, so it is just adding another layer of volume and 3D look to the hair. Let's plug in the other textures. So I will drag and drop them in here. First I will drag and drop the directional pass to the flow map slot, then root map, and finally ID map. You don't see any changes in the hair look because we have to change the shader properties to use those bottom maps. I will now set up the specular highlights, because right now you almost do not see them at all. So you can do this from this parameter panel. In here we can reduce the roughness of the specular highlights, and it has actually a big influence over how the hair looks. I will explain you how the specular work by maybe reducing the opacity to very low value. And you may see it is the specular is splitted into two highlights. I will explain you how this works by changing maybe the color to darker red, and now it is easy to see that one of the highlights is colored also to red and one is white. This is how usually hair shaders are made in game engines, and usually you want the colored highlight to be below the white highlight. You can flip this using this checkbox flip tangent map. Now it is behaving correctly, so I can increase roughness again. And it is easy to control. You can reduce only the white specular highlight strength using this slider. Then you can reduce the colored highlight strength using the second slider. And if you want, you can control both of them using this map strength, like so. So I will revert the diffuse to default color, like so. And one problem for me with those highlights is that they are looking a bit flat. I want for them to have more interesting shape. And you can tweak the shape of the highlights by using this specular direction panel. And you have to input ID map first, but you can remember that we already inputted the ID map. So what this additional slider, what are they doing? They are tweaking the look of the specular highlights. So maybe it will be easier to see on darker color like this. So by tweaking the parameters in the specular direction, you see that the highlight silhouette is changing. Two big values are breaking the illusion, but if you do not change this too much, you will have this more interesting look in the highlights. So let's reset the diffuse again, and I will explain you now the root map and ID map. It is actually quite simple. The root map has two parameters, one for root color, like this, and one for the ending color in here. And in the advanced properties, you can reduce the influence of this effect, change the blend mode, or you can disable this effect only on the roots or only on the endings. And you can also invert this effect. Now let's jump to the ID map. But first I will maybe darken the hair color like so, so it will be easier to see the influence of the root map. And maybe I will reduce also the specular strength color like so. And now let's jump to the ID map. If I increase this influence, you see the random hair strands are colored to this one color. So if I change this, we have effect like this. And usually I use this ID map for gray hair effect. And for gray hair, usually you want the hair strands to be gray only on the endings. So I will first maybe reduce the affected range of the hair strands like this, so there will be not as many white hair strands. And now I want this effect to be only on the endings. You can do this in advanced properties. I can mask the effect of the ID map using this slider, but now it is only affecting the roots. I want this masking effect to be inverted, and there is this invert slider. And now the gray hair is only being displayed on the bottom. So this way you have convincing looking gray hair. And that covers the ID map. There is second slider for ID map, but it is behaving exactly the same. It is just giving you more control over the hair look. So finally, I wanted to show you one thing about the increasing the realism of the hair. So if you have maybe the brighter hair, maybe I will color it like so. And for bright hair, usually there is more light scattering happening in the hair strands, and usually you should not see as many dark spots. So to get rid of them, you can just reduce the influence of this blend shader like so. So already it is looking nicer and less dirty. And then we can also reduce the influence of the vertex color, maybe something like that. And with that, the hair is looking softer and less dirty, so just remember, you can tweak the hair look. Reallusion has more accurate and advanced tutorials about the hair shader in Character Creator. You can check them by visiting links in the description of the video. Hope you like this video, and see ya.